Hello children, welcome back to the IVS class. Today we are going to start the new lesson, that is the clothes. Today we are starting the new lesson about the clothes. Okay children, before starting the chapter, let me ask you that why we need the clothes? Why we should wear the clothes? Yes, why we should wear the clothes? To cover our bodies, that you all know. To cover our bodies, we are going to wear the clothes. Why we should cover our bodies? Yes, because the clothes protect us from the insect bites. It protects us from the heat, rain and cold. According to the seasons, we are going to wear the clothes. Right? Yes, children. Today in this chapter, we are going to learn more about the clothes. Okay? The clothes speak about the persons also here. About the people it speaks. How it going to speak? What are the different kinds of clothes are there? Okay? From where we'll get the clothes? Okay? In which season, what type of clothes we should wear? Everything we are going to learn in this chapter. Okay. Let us start now. Lesson number 8, clothes. We wear clothes to cover our bodies. Clothes protect us from heat, cold and rain. They also protect us from insect bites. We wear clothes according to the seasons. So, as I told you that we wear clothes to cover our bodies and the clothes protect us from the insect bites and heat, rain and cold. Then we will wear the clothes according to the seasons, that is winter season, summer season and rainy season. Okay? Yes. In summer, we'll go for the summer now. Summer season. In summer, it is very hot. Right? In summer season, it is very hot. We like to wear cotton clothes. They are light and keep us cool. Yes, children? In the summer season, what type of clothes we are wearing? Cotton clothes. Why we are wearing these cotton clothes? Because they are very light. It's not very heavy. It is very light and it keeps our body cool. Okay? Cotton clothes also absorb sweat that comes from our body. What this cotton clothes will do? It will absorb the sweat. During summer only, sweating will be more, right? So, in that season, we are wearing cotton clothes. Why we are wearing cotton clothes? The cotton clothes absorbs the sweat coming from our body. It absorbs the sweat and it will keep us cool. So, we are wearing cotton clothes in the summer season. See, summer season is very hot. Okay? So, it's very hot. Cotton clothes we are wearing. During summer season, we are wearing cotton clothes. Okay? Because these cotton clothes, what it will do? It will absorb the sweat. What it will do? Absorb sweat. Absorb sweat coming from our body and it also keeps us cool. Okay, next. In winter, the days are cold. We like to wear woolen clothes. These clothes keep us warm. What do you mean by that? In winter season, the days are cold. We like to wear woolen clothes. In the winter season, days will be very cold. Very cold. So that time, what type of clothes we are wearing? Woolen clothes we are wearing. Why we are wearing woolen clothes? Woolen clothes, it keeps us warm. So, woolen clothes keeps us warm. Okay, when we are wearing the woolen clothes? During winter season. Okay, next. In rainy season, it rains often. On a rainy day, we use umbrellas and wear raincoats when we go outdoors. They keep us dry. What do you mean by this? In rainy season, it will be raining. Often and often it will be rains, no? It will be raining, no? On a rainy day, what we'll wear that time, what we'll do? We'll take the umbrellas and we'll go outside. If you're going for outdoors, we'll hold the umbrellas. Otherwise, we'll wear the raincoats. Okay? In the rainy season, raincoats we'll use. We'll use the raincoats. Okay? Next. Some people do special jobs. These people wear uniforms that suit their jobs. You can identify them by looking at their uniforms. You also wear uniform at your school. Some people will wear the uniforms. No, children, when you go for the schools, what type of dress you'll wear? What type of clothes you'll wear? Uniform clothes. Yes, no? So that only I told that some people's, the clothes talk about the people's, I told, persons. There's no how he talks, this is the way it talks. Okay, some people will wear the uniforms according to their jobs. Okay, see for example, doctor. Okay, doctor uniform is different. Yes, no? Nurse. Postman uniform is different and soldier uniforms also different. So, what it will say, it is going to speak about the people. Okay, it will speak about the uniform, speak about the people. Speak about people. As I told, doctor uniform is different. If he is wearing the coat white color, then we'll say him as doctor, right? Nurse uniform is different. Postman uniform is different. Soldier's uniform is different. Yes, no? These are the uniform wear by the persons who are doing in the special jobs. Okay? Next. People in our country wear different dresses. Yes, no? In our country, there are many states. Yes, no? Many states are there. According to the states, they are wearing the clothes. Okay? You can see in the West Bengal what type of clothes they will wear. You can see the picture in your textbook. See West Bengal clothes, how they are wearing dresses, Kerala dresses, and Maharashtra, Orissa, Jammu and Kashmir. This you can see in your textbook how they are wearing the dresses according to the their culture. Okay, this is how different dresses also they are wearing. Next, materials for clothing. So the main thing, how we are getting the materials for clothing. Okay, we'll see that. Clothes are made from different materials like cotton, wool and silk. Okay, what are the types of materials they're using? For clothing, what are the materials they're using? Cotton they're using, wool they're using and silk also they're using. Cotton, wool and silk they're using for the clothing. Okay, where we'll get the cotton, where we'll get the wool and where we'll get the silk, we'll see now. Cotton clothes are made of cotton. We get cotton from cotton plants. Cotton is spun into the threads called yarns. Yarns are spun and woven into the clothes in textile mills. Okay, how they are doing here? Cotton, we are getting from the cotton plant. Cotton plant, have you seen? Yes, you see once how the cotton plant is. You can see the picture here. The cotton plant's picture. Okay. This cotton, they will take and span into the threads. They will span into the threads that is called yarn. Like a yarn they will do. Okay. Then yarns are spun again, woven into the clothes. In textile mills, you can see this. If once possible, go and see the textile mills, how they are doing. Okay, they will make as a thread in the textile mills and they are going to weave it. Okay, like that we are getting cotton from cotton plants. Okay, Next, woolen clothes. Woolen clothes are made of wool. We get wool from the sheep. Wool is the hair that grows on a sheep's body. So in the woolen clothes, we are getting woolen clothes from the wool. That wool from where we are getting, that is nothing but the hair grows on the sheep. The hair grows on the sheep, no? From that we are getting wool. Okay, from that wool we are making woolen clothes. Okay, next, silk. The silk. Silk clothes are made of silk. Silk comes from an insect called silkworm. So, from where we'll get the silk here? Insect, have you seen the silkworm insect? How many of them have seen? Yes, how it looks? How it looks? It's very small, small silkworms you can see. Yes, no? So, from that silkworm, they're going to get the silk. How? See. This silkworm spins a thread around its body in a round shape. It is called cocoon. Okay, the silkworm will be there, no? It is going to spin a thread. Okay, like roundly it's going to spin around the body. This is called cocoons, we call it. We call it as cocoons. Cocoons are boiled and silk threads are separated from them. So here afterwards they are going to boil the silkworms. Okay, the cocoons will be there, no? That they will take and they will start boiling it. When it boils, the thread will be separated. Okay, from them silk clothes are very durable and attractive. So only these silk clothes, it's very attractive and it's very durable also. Durable means very costly, also expensive we can say. Okay, so this is how you are getting the silk. And how you are getting the cotton clothes here now? From where you will get the cotton clothes? From the cotton plant. From where you will get the wool? Yes. What do you mean by wool? Nothing but the hair grows on the sheep. Yes, no. So how you will get the silk now? From silkworm. Okay, what is cocoon? The silkworm spins a thread around its body in a round shape. It is called a cocoon. Okay, what they will do that cocoon? They will boil. They will start boiling. Afterwards, what will get from that? The thread will be separated. Okay, its silk is very durable and attractive. Next, we all came to know that how we'll get the clothes. What are the materials used for clothing? We know that in both seasons we are wearing different types of clothes. We have seen that, and special people who are doing special jobs, no? They are using uniform. That we have came to know that. At last, very important, how to care for clothes. Caring for clothes. Everybody in all the houses, there will be a lot of clothes. Yes, no? So how you are going to take care of the clothes? We should take proper care of our clothes. Here are a few tips that will help you to keep your clothes safe. Wash your clothes with a good detergent. What they are saying, first you have to keep your clothes properly. Where you have to keep your clothes properly? Where you will keep? The kapoots you will keep? Yes, you have to keep it properly. First what you should do? You should wash the clothes with good detergents. Okay, good detergents you should wash your clothes. Then you have to iron them properly. After washing, what you have to do? You should iron it. Okay, iron them properly. Next, keep your clothes in a shelf or in a cupboard. After ironing, what you want to do? You should keep the clothes in a shelf otherwise or in the cupboard. Keep your clothes away from insects and mice. Very important. You should always keep your clothes away from the insects. Okay, some insects will go and it will bite the clothes. Right? So mice also will do this. Mice also. So what we have to do? What we have to do? We should keep away from the insect and mice. Okay, children? Now you have understood about the clothes? Yes. Very good. Next. Okay, let me wrap up. We wear clothes to cover our bodies. We wear cotton clothes. When will we wear the cotton clothes? Summer. We wear woolen clothes. In winter, we wear raincoats and use umbrellas on a rainy day. People who do special jobs will wear uniforms. We should take care of our clothes. Okay, do you understand the lesson now? Yes. So, you have to read the lesson, children. In the next class, I will teach you how to read the lesson. Okay, thank you.